Okay, all right, so back to this ridiculous sheet. It's finished. I keep saying it's finished, and then I'm like, well, I don't know. I ended up tweaking it a little bit today. I made it a little more user-friendly, so it's not just like assumption based on certain select numbers. You can put in your exact known net worth, like precise, and your exact known price of the house. So I'm kind of distraught because I was making the sheet for like a couple hours working on all of these little extra things I added, and then for some reason I didn't save it, and I clicked on the thing and it just dropped out, and it hadn't been rolling the saves through for some reason, and I lost all the data and I had to go back, and so I cried, and so now I'm here at it again, and I redid all of the math, so it's there again. And it real and I what it does is anything under like 5,000, I'm really going with a standard set, a government fee of 4.5 to help that low net worth person. Okay, now not all of it. Now this is something new I added. Not all of that 4.5 is going to be necessarily required. It may be just part of it. So if there's any like leftover down payment, that goes back. That's going to be refunded back to the government. So the 4.5 is just there to be present at that moment. All of it could be used, but chances are much of it can be returned as well. So that's nice. And I did put that inclusion where the seller has the option to say, I don't actually want the cash at that moment. I would prefer it all on the voucher. So they can put it all on their property voucher, and if they do that, then that even more of the money goes back to the government. So the government wouldn't have had to foot the bill for that person, that seller as well. Because that's what it is the buyer has to get this credit, and then he has to give the credit to the seller. And if the seller says, no, I don't really need the credit, then the government doesn't have to spend that extra money, and so it just helps out. And that, like I was saying, if they say they're not going to use the credit, not want the cash, I put a place in there and everything. You just put yes or no if they want the cash, and this is for all everything under 50,000. Then if that's the way it was, they don't want the cash, then they get. Then that goes off later on. They can use it as a credit somehow, maybe as a deduction. Because I guess, we can't apparently change the system and just say, can't we just turn off the keys of this current government and just do everything different? It doesn't seem to be like there's anything in place. It doesn't seem like there's been anything written. It seems like this is all just like the unmagic toast that is never going to happen. And unless this is it, you start putting things like this, a zero rated interest possibility offered through the government. You start putting that into the system, little by little, maybe we can make changes. But right now, I'm not seeing any big major change possible. Of just, throwing out this monster. Let's see, where am I? What else did I do with that? So really, that was the gist of it. So if you know the price, it'll be more precision. And yeah, it's just y'all are in tonight. About nothing. We have the, I don't know. I've Yeah, it's pretty much all updated. So like right here, it'll say the buyer in this instance. Oh, I know what I did. So now the houses, they don't have to be 50,000. Now they can actually be anywhere from 13,500. I put a stipulator in to 50,000 for the 4,500 affronted money from the government. That down payment fronted closing from the government. Okay, so those houses, those people that have low net worth, They can now the house is available. I opened that up so they can have the 13.5, although I guess that would even be a yurt property. So they could be the 13.5 all the way up to the 50,000. So that's something interesting also. Anyway, that was it. That was it. Yeah, closing paid by government in cash. And so now so here in this instance, it was a $30,000 investment, some type of house. It could be a tiny home for 30,000. And there it is, and with land or something. And so at the end of the day, at the beginning, the government puts that 4.5 out there. But the seller said he didn't want all the cash. He didn't want his cash portion. Instead, he decided to put it all on a voucher. So he saved the government quite a bit, in that instance. So anyway, so that's really what I've been doing today. Okay, enough. Yeah, enough. It's over.